My name is Michael Roper. My nickname or puppet name is Puppet Master, but I go by Puppet for short because it's a lot easier to say. I consider myself a popper. It's one of the elements of breakdancing, which is devised of popping, breaking, locking, and freestyle. It's called popping. Popping basically consists of distorting your body or making yourself basically look like an animated film or something unreal. As far as the history, popping kind of evolved. There was a dance which was called locking, which was basically invented by a guy named Camelot. The style of boogaloo came from the Pepto-Bismol commercial, which was playing a big thing back then, where they would say enter, gesture, and from there the body wave was formed, and then it went from there to the arm wave, and like I said, the boogaloo, and that's basically where it started, you know. And then of course the robot started to get mixed in. That's what really started to change a lot. It was something to keep me out of trouble. It was something to work at, to get better at. And I think the biggest thing was the competition. That adrenaline, trying to be the best, you know, to go against other people and test your skills, basically. And that's basically what it was all about. There was no money involved or anything else. It was just your skills against theirs. Breakdancing has, or street dancing, correct that, basically has kept me away from the game, because I would have definitely been in the game if it wasn't for the street dancing. One of the movies that I was really, most people know me from was Electric Boogaloo Breaking Part 2. It was a little small part, but it was a part that really got a lot of notice. The biggest difference between then and now is now you got tapes you can watch. Back then, you have nothing to watch, so it was all done on basic, you know, you discover or figure out a move and you practice it. Now, you can see the moves, see them perfected, and learn them, and basically go off of that. So it's actually a lot easier for the guys today than before. Well, what I see in the future is breakdancing being something even as big as part of the Olympics. I mean, because it's a skill that you just can't do. It's a learned skill. You have to perfect it and become good at it. And even though you do that, only certain people can really do it good. So that's something that I definitely can see in the future. Hopefully we can see another big trend in the movies. Because a lot of people put a lot of time and effort in this type of dance, and you know, it's nice if people can get compensated, you know, for the type of, you know, practice and effort they put into it.